Today we will be understanding white papers and general documentations for projects before investing.
Crypto Media Service, bringing you in-depth thoughts on cryptocurrencies.
We will continue to look at BitGuild. The reason I have chosen BitGuild is that I have no financial incentive in keeping my focus there. I could use a lot of other projects which I am invested in. But that would, well, that might be an interest conflict because I have financial incentive. I don't have it with BitGuild. They have neither contacted me and I have not invested in them. So let's continue. Let's jump right over there to BitGuild's main site. We are now here at BitGuild. And up in the top, they have a button called Resources. That is where we are at. And as you can see, they have a one-pager, white paper, and smart contract documentation. So let's start with the one paper. Here we get a little information about who they are, what is in it for the gamers, what is in it for the developers. This is meant to give us an overview. You should not use this as any form of financial investment backing. This is just an overview of what we are going to be looking close at later. Then I will be looking at the team and the advisory team. This one has been changed. So let's just, while we're looking at the one paper, let's go over to the team. Jared Sagoda, CEO, just another picture, but same guy, matches. Oh. Curtis Choi, COO, that matches. Sean Keith, VP Business Development, Sean Keith, he's still there. CTO Mikhail Larinov, or something like that. Well, still another picture, but same guy. The advisor. Well, we know from the last program that these two are in the advisory board. There and there. But Liu Wang is the third one, not the 2100 Founder Club. This might be because this is an old paper from when they had their ICO. But I would be a little skeptical when those things doesn't match. Let's move on. We have the ICO details. It's a great overview, this one, because you get the private sale, the public sale, how big it is, what's the cap, soft cap, hard cap, when does it start, when does it end, the distribution of tokens, and the allocation of funds. All of this, if you have read it all, you would have a good overview. A idea of what this project is about. And before we move further in, I just have a little word for you to say. And we have moved over to the white paper. BitGuild blockchain gaming platform. All right. First of all, I would, if I were to invest in this project, since it's all over, I cannot. But if I were, I would read the entire white paper. But there are some things here I would have extra focus on. All of this up here, abstract. Let's go down to the abstract. This is a bit about how it's going to function. A little history. This might give a good in sentiment for why their platform should be good. The dark side of free to play. And if you are a little into gaming or movies, you would notice that this should look like Star Wars character Darth Vader. As we say, the dark side. So they at least make a link towards the players that they want to get into the project and want to support the project. And it goes on to describing why there are some, well, negative sides to free to play. Sorry. Now we come down to where I will put a little extra effort in making sure I understand the case for blockchain games. And this is just an overview of an introduction overview, called what you want, to why blockchain-based gaming has a good future. And a little bit about the trading and how it functions and why it's true microtransactions and so on. So let's jump right back up to this site here. The platform, I would also make an effort in making sure I understand completely. Because the platform is, well, the first thing the player will meet. The token sale, I would make sure I just understand. I would not go extremely in depth with it. The use of proceeds, I will familiarize myself with that. Roadmap. This is where it gets interesting. Because as we move down to the roadmap, I will always look, is it realistic? Depending on the team size, and it is extremely subjective. But do I believe they can hold their roadmap? If I think the roadmap is too tight, I will consider not investing. And then you have the team, but we have already looked at the team. I would check up because this one, as a advisor, an early supporter, doesn't stand on their side. Also check up on him. I am but if they check out as being supporters, I have no doubt they will. Risk a disclaimer, always make sure you understand it. And then let's go back down to looking at the platform. Look at how it's written. If it's filled with inconsistencies, bad wording, bad spelling, I would not invest. But looking at how they have chosen to set up the site, game platform, short descriptions, highlights in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5s. And then again, it's written in small paragraphs, easy to understand. And still they have the technical data in here. So it looks promising, but if they begin to contradict themselves. If they have no technical data, I would skip it. When all of this checks out, I'll say, okay, this is interesting. Let's see what else we can do to find out more about this project. They had a resource called the BitGuild token contract. I was just a little bit down here. Hosting BitGuild token contract audit by Hoso. If you don't know who Hoso is, I would check them out, see if they have made any other contract audits. Now I know a little bit about Hoso, so I take them quite serious. And as you can see, their contract is passing. It is not all the way in the top, which means, well, it delivers what they promise. It could be better, but it checks out. And the test table code, it's a little bit below average, but it is so little that it's nothing to be worried about. Some will go a little above, some will go a little below. It is still within the average, because this is an average standard. So some will be above, some will be a little below. You should be worried if it were all the way down here, or if it's the slider here was down in the yellow side. If it were in the black, well, I would move on. Even if it's down in the yellow, I will not trust it. So for the full data, I would read it, because Osho has written it in a language that is, well, easy to understand if you have the slightest technical knowledge. And if you have any doubts about something, then try to find a YouTube video explaining this. But if you just spend a little time understanding ERC-20 contracts, you would know that you don't need this. You can look at this. You can look at what they test. You can look at what they write. And we will move longer down. And you will keep on reading down and down and down. What I'm also interested in is something like this. Non-compliance built. The latest standard requires that an approval event is fired on successful call to a provider. So they have some flaws in their code, but it is still passed. Here is what checks out. The result should deploy a token with the proper configurations. Should allocate tokens per the minting function. Should not transfer negative token amount. Should not transfer more token than you have. All of these checks out, which is something we like. I would look for something that does not check out. If everything checks out, well, I'm confident. And especially because this audit is from a third party. And you can actually double check it through other channels, such as Hoso themselves. While we have been through all of these resources, they have no more. But they do link us to their Reddit, their YouTube, Facebook, Twitter, and a notice board on Medium. So you have different ways of getting some community input, especially on Reddit. If you don't know what Reddit is, it's giant forums on forums. And you will be able to read what people are thinking about the project and go into the comments and say, oh, good project, I believe this project is. If you begin to check it out on Reddit, I have two pointers for you. Don't focus on the positive. And does the negative sound reliable, feasible? Don't focus on the direct, oh, I like this or I dislike this. Focus on what they're saying. A good way of focusing on what they're saying is to read what they're saying. And, well, how do I put this in the right way? If someone says this is bad, ask yourself why. If someone says this is good, ask yourself why. If they do give arguments of why this is good or bad, then you can use it. You cannot use good, bad. You can use this is good because yada yada yada. Or this is bad because yada 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 yada. Hopefully this gave you a little insight into how I look at the resources. Next time we will be talking social media, how to investigate social media. My name is has been the Golden Boy, and this has been Crypto Media Service. Remember, stay safe out there, do your due diligent research, and I'll see you next time.